and welcome to our third episode of Fresh. I'm Jess.
And I'm Phil. We've got a cracking episode lined up this week. We have a review of Black Ops 2 by Mike, our tech guy. An interview with Peace at Soon, a great band from Columbia Records, based in Birmingham. A lot of hype on them right now.
Yeah, really exciting. It'll be good to go and find out a bit more about them. Firstly, though, we sent Helen down to a new store opening in Morgan's Arcade.
Yeah, Street Casuals.
Yeah, it's good clothes, and I think it'll be
Very good
little interview.
Let's check it out.
We're here at the grand opening of Street Casual in the Morgan Arcade. We've got great music here and great clothes and DJ, so let's go and take a look. Okay, I'm here now with Will, who's the owner of Street Casual. So can you tell us a bit about your brand?
We started about 2 years ago as an online retailer, and we've just opened our first bricks and mortar store in Cardiff. University students, really, is generally our target market.
Brilliant. Okay, well, that's good for us, obviously.
We started off as basically mainly a music and events night. That built up then into a promotions and marketing company, to which we've got many different clients in Cardiff. We work from everything from tattoo parlours to letting agencies. That's built up then for us to want to start to do a pop-up shop. The pop-up shop, with the success of it, then built up to something now we're doing an 18-month lease.
All right, so we're going to take a look at some of the clothes now. Can you show us what you've got here?
Yeah, sure. First off, Penfield for ladies. This has been a really strong seller, which is the Rockwool jacket, Downfield, Shirling collar. It's a really, really great winter jacket. So definitely recommended, one of our best sellers. Menswear, we do very well with Dunderdun, which is a Scandinavian workwear brand. So that sells for, you know, less than £200, but it's a really good winter jacket. Highly recommended. One of the more fashion-forward brands we do is Libertine, which is, again, Scandinavian streetwear brand. Nice with the all-over animal print. Strong for this season. And then some of the smaller brands that we do. One of our best sellers is African Apparel, which is a Bristol brand that we're doing a collaboration with for next summer. So that's a new release just in today. And American brand, Crooks and Castles, which again, really good seller for us, with a nice Faro print.
So yeah, we basically started FAO about a year and a half ago now. We've been running out of Undertone and Buffalo for a good few months now. We've had some really good underground house music nights since. We've got Marabou Steak coming up.
23rd November. We've got Crystal Clear, and then 7th of December, and then Leon Vinyl and the Organ Grinder on the 14th of December.
Possibly a big one coming up in February.
We're not
going to
say
any more about that. Possibly the Union, but we'll leave it at that. Thank you.
Thanks for that, Helen. That was a great look at the brand new store, Street Casual. So get yourself down to Morgan's Arcade if you want to get involved with those clothes.
Yeah, I like the look of that blue shirt. The leopard print one. I might check that out.
That would look good on
Plus,
you.
Plus, 10% student discount. So
10% student discount. Perfect. Okay.
Fantastic, isn't it? Yeah. But next up, we have an interview with Peace. These are a great band from Birmingham, signed to Columbia Records. Only released an EP, and there's already so much hype around them. In fact, they even got them on Billboard in Birmingham, their hometown.
Which is hilarious.
Yes, check it out. We can't say what it says, but check it out online. It's definitely worth a look. But anyway, yeah, we sent down Gus and Stu, so check it out.
This is Gus and Stu, CTV, and we're at Stu Festival with Peace. How are we, boys?
Good.
We're all good. We're good.
Too good for...
Okay. I'm fine.
Have you managed to catch any bands since you've been here at Soon?
No, we haven't yet. Have we?
Unfortunately not, no.
Almost. Have you seen anyone in the bill you'd like to see?
We were going to watch Drench, but we had to meet you instead. But that's not a disappointment.
So you've been hit like a lot of the plays from Guardian, Enemy, then your new Corinthian, Wonderwall, that's what you got. Is that...
It is in some ways, but but it's kind of like we're more than happy to just come and do exactly what we're doing, and it's all right.
Avoid pressure.
Yeah.
So what have the next 12 months got in store for
me? I think one album
and a lot of shows. Just keep on doing what we've been doing. I think we don't have any like big things planned except for releasing an album, really. I looked at my iCal, which is synced with my GCal earlier, and nothing past December is quite worrying, actually. Actually, no, that billboard, but I can't go into it. I actually had a really interesting idea about like a series of billboards, because we need to step it up a notch, but it isn't fully formed yet, so I don't want to bust it out.
Can you tell us the story behind the whole billboard thing?
It was kind of a jest with our manager. He said, we'll only sign to Columbia if they buy us a billboard with our faces on and What the Fuck Birmingham on it. Or if they put the contract in Comic Sans, the font, and they chose the billboard. It was a joke, but they took it seriously, and then they must hate Comic Sans.
Are you surprised to know whether they actually got some media or not?
No. Are you surprised?
No.
No. I am. I'm genuinely surprised. Yeah. I didn't think we were all that. I thought there was room for improvement.
How's it going in your hometown of Birmingham? Are you hometown
here
yet?
We haven't been there for a while because we've been away, but our friends are all proud, our parents are all proud, and I think people like us.
No, I think we've lost all our friends from Birmingham now. Like, there's just us four. Those are all my friends. Those are the only people I know now.
The Guardian and Enemy have compared you to bands like Foles and Woo Life. What do you think of that? Is that welcome, or do you want to sort of do your own thing?
It was a fair kind of point to make when people hadn't heard much of our stuff, when there was only like one song out or two songs out. But the more people hear, I think, the more diverse their opinion becomes.
That was a brilliant interview there with the boys from Peace.
Yeah, and if you thought that interview, you can find that as well as others such as Palmer Violets and Django Django on our website, which is cardiffstreetmedia.co.uk /CTV.
Yeah, make sure you check that out.
Yeah, but last but not least, we have Mike from our tech segment. How are you, mate?
Yeah, I'm all right. I have a preview of Call of Duty Black Ops 2. Some amazing footage there, so check it out.
This week saw the release of Black Ops 2, the newest installment of the Call of Duty franchise. Already well established as one of the most popular shooters around, the series and its notoriously addictive multiplayer has returned to wreck your schedule as you rack up killstreaks and headshots. The game's campaign takes place in 2025, in which the US is embroiled in a new Cold War with China. Released to positive acclaim, Black Ops 2 has had an incredibly successful launch. Industry analysts have posited that the game sold nearly 8 million copies in its first 24 hours,